It's 9:38 a.m. Thursday, 10th March.
And welcome to BBC School Report from the Knights Templar School.
We have three stories shot and edited by pupils from KTS Towers.
After 500,000 signatures to ban US presidential candidate Donald Trump from the UK, we find out why he's so unpopular and discover if this could really happen.
But most importantly, we find out your views.
In other news, our school rugby teams have their best ever season,
winning 4 out of 5 district finals.
We interviewed the captains and head coach, Mr. Smith. But our lead news story is brass player Ben Coltrane's continued success.
After playing for the Philharmonia and being a finalist for the BBC Young Brass Award in 2015, Ben prepared to compete in BBC Young Musician of the Year. Lua reports.
French horn phenomenon Ben Goldschneider has been shortlisted for the BBC Young Brass Musician of the Year for the 3rd time in 3 years. But how did he get to where he is today?
What has been the highlight of your career so far?
Thank you, Louis. Ben is certainly an inspiration for me.
Hold on, you sing like a cat on a malfunctioning roller coaster.
Too true, but how bad would I be without the maestro's inspiration?
More fantastic achievements now as Louis scrums down with 3 rugby captains and Mr. Smith.
Best of luck.
Knights Templar has a reputation for sporting achievement, and this rugby season has proved it is well earned, with 4 teams emerging victorious. I talked to 3 of the champions to find out more.
How proud were you to captain the winning team?
Really proud. I mean, in year 7 we weren't really working as a team, but gradually we got higher and higher together and we're a really good team at the moment.
How does it feel for you to get this far?
At the start of the season I didn't think we'd get this far, but now we've improved and I'm happy we beat the team that beat us.
What did it mean to you to win the districts?
It means quite a lot. We've done it. We did it in year 7, year 8, but then unfortunately we lost it in year 9, and now it's become a bigger league for us to win it. against a team who like kind of ran over us earlier on. It's like a great success.
How long have you been coaching the rugby team?
Well, I've started at Knights Templar 6 years ago. It's my 6th year, so I've been in charge of rugby since then, and I've sort of taken responsibility of the year 10s since they were in year 7. Like Josh said, massive achievement and massive amount of progress, really. And I know from speaking from Mr. Fisher, Mr. Bradley, and Mr. Barrows, who's coached the year 7s and 8s, just about how much progress has been made is like the massive positive from us, really.
What's it like seeing all 4 teams being so successful?
Personal satisfaction, really. It's my job to try and make Knights Templar a really successful rugby school, and to get 4 out of 5 year groups winning the district league is absolutely superb. We've even got county semi-finals coming up for the year 10s really shortly, which is again raising the level even more, and again that would be a fantastic achievement if we could do that one too.
What were some memorable moments when coaching this season?
I think it's just mainly, like Josh said, and it's similar to the year 7 and 8 teams. We played the team that we played in the final earlier on in the season. We got beat, and I think we got beat quite comprehensively in each year group. So then to turn it around and sort of see the dedication that we saw at training and the sort of the intensity and the really positive attitude from the boys, and then just back that up with a fantastic performance under real pressure in the final, was, I just thought, was absolutely superb.
Yeah, not longer in the season we played Barnwell, and they did beat us by quite a lot, but we played them again in the final. We managed to beat them.
Yeah, well, in the final we did a set piece move, and it was a great team try as we built like the pressure on them, and then we did the set piece, and the ball went out to the wing, and the wing crossed in the corner with some great passing along the way.
In our first game we were down by about 3 or 4 tries, and the first try we scored was a great team one.
Recently, there's been talk on banning tackling for students under the age of 18. What do you think of this?
I think contact's part of the game and it's fun when it's wet and muddy.
Probably it's like one of the worst decisions for quite a while, because contact is like a key part of the game, and personally I love it. I love tackling people. It's like, yeah, that's it.
It's silly really, because tackling's one of the key aspects of the rugby game. I really like doing it myself.
I don't personally agree with it. If you listen to what the 3 captains have said there, part of the game that they enjoy the most is the contact side of it. If you coach correctly, it's safe, so you hopefully are going to reduce the likelihood of getting injured. But also, we've got a really successful international team, and if we are having young boys practicing their tackling, how are we going to carry that on? So I think it should stay.
Thank you. Brilliant.
Cheers.
This script says Trump. We can't say that. It's the BBC School Report, not KTS Newscast.
Yes, we can, as it's the unfortunate moniker of Donald J. Trump.
Ah, him. So we discover why he's such a divisive figure, and if he can really be banned from blighting. Jason reports.
Donald J. Trump has dominated the media since announcing for his intention to run for US President as a Republican candidate, with his incredibly controversial opinions and beliefs, such as Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States. So big, so strong, so powerful, nobody is going to mess with us. I will build a great, great wall on our southern border, and I will make Mexico pay for that wall. You have the constitutional right to keep and bear arms. They want to take that away. A parliamentary campaign has seen thousands of Britons demand that Donald Trump be denied entry to the UK.
But I wanted to raise the question of why this online petition, which has been signed by 3,000 of my constituents in Hampstead and Kilburn, has evoked such emotion.
Joe finds out more. Why should Donald Trump not be allowed into the UK?
Some people have been really unhappy with things that Donald Trump has said as part of the US presidential election campaign. And as a result, they set up a petition on the Parliament website to say that they didn't want Donald Trump to come into the UK. That received hundreds of thousands of signatures. And as a result, Parliament discussed it. The reason why they set up this petition was that they were concerned that what Donald Trump was saying could cause problems for people that live in this country, because they considered some of his statements to have been racist and discriminatory.
Who has the final decision?
It's up to the Home Secretary, Theresa May, to make a decision as to whether or not someone is allowed or not allowed to come into the country. She has used this power in the past to stop people who have been convicted of crimes such as murder or rape, or are involved in terrorism or drugs. And she has also used it to stop people coming in who practice what we call hate speech. And that is the reason why people think that this time Donald Trump should be banned, and it's for Theresa May to make a decision as to whether or not she considers his language to be hate speech, or whether or not it is part of a reasonable debate on issues.
Who will actually benefit from him coming in?
Well, why would Donald Trump want to come over to the UK during a US presidential election campaign? Firstly, because the United Kingdom is a very close ally of the United States, and he would want to show that he would maintain that strong alliance, that strong friendship with the United Kingdom. But Donald Trump has visited the UK a number of times before. He's been involved in some business in Scotland, so setting up a new golf course and resort up there, which is part of his empire of companies. So that clearly does have a benefit to people in terms of jobs and the economy in that area. But I would think that Donald Trump has proved very popular with people who are more right-wing in their opinions in the United States, and he's really infused a lot of those people. And if he were to visit the UK and he were to give speeches and talk in the same way as he has done in the United States, he might have that similar effect on people here.
Is it ever right to ban someone from coming into a country?
Well, as I said before, the Home Secretary has this power because she has a responsibility to protect people. And it is wrong for people who have been convicted of serious crimes in other countries, for them then to be able to travel to other countries because they are a threat to people here. It's also not right for people to be able to preach certain views that are going to cause divisions and potentially violence towards particular communities to come over here and use that language and use their words that they've used to stir that up in other countries in this country. So that is the decision that the Home Secretary has to make, and that is why she has that power.
Thank you to Mr. Sherry for being such a great sport and redoing his interview 3 times in total.
Due to technical difficulties.
At School Report, we don't blame individuals for mistakes, because it's just wrong.
And Mr. McDowell wouldn't be happy.
What? Did he mess up?
Not saying. I want to keep my job.
So let's now go over to Weather and Bulldog and the surrounding villages.
Thanks, Joel and Jason. It looks like another great day for Bulldog, Ashwell, the Mordens, Weston and Bygrave, reaching a high of 10 degrees Celsius. This will drop overnight to an expected -1, but don't worry, we're back up to a tropic 2 degrees Celsius tomorrow.
BBC School Report is about to draw to a close after the Fast Fire News Fiesta that is 60 seconds news.
Thank you, Jason and Joel. Year 8 fencing superstar Dylan Daniel has been selected to represent England under-15's international fencing tournament in Poland in March. An incredible feature for a pupil who is just 12 years old. Katius went international over the spring half term, with history A-level students visiting Berlin in Germany and the senior football team touring to Eindhoven in Holland.
Leo Norvin in Year 8 is to be a contestant on the new CBBC show coming up in June called Airmageddon, a competition for children flying drones around obstacle courses, testing their speed, agility and skills along the way. Make sure to check that out soon.
Katie's senior basketball team competed for the district trophy. Despite a great performance, our team lost by just 3 points.
And finally, the school's newspaper, Newsnight, is celebrating its first year online, publishing articles every week, including news, reviews and editorials. Visit ktsnewsnight.com to find out more.
I hope you've enjoyed BBC School Report from KTS Towers.
As much as we've enjoyed running the show.
Thanks to our sixth form helpers, Jess, Polly, Robin and Bill.
See you next at KTS Newscast.
Goodbye. Bye.